The review was set up after a spate of motorway accidents drew attention to the death and casualty toll from motorway crashes. Here on the M4 last September, four people died and 74 were injured in one pile-up alone. But the statistics show that less than one in every 20 road deaths happens on motorways. They are, it seems, the safest roads in the country. What today's new measures aim to do is make them safer. The South East has some of the worst motorway trouble spots. This Contraflow on the M11 is going to be here until September. Officers reckon the biggest problem at Contraflow systems is simply this: people drive too fast. On this stretch, the police applied for and got a mandatory 50-mile-an-hour speed limit, though that doesn't stop some people.
Well, there was a BMW passed us at a fairly high speed. We were up to 80 miles an hour. The other car's pulled over, so he's still going. Let's drop a gear and go. Now, look, that's exactly what I mean. Right at the last minute, he's gone across.
This driver got away with a bit of advice. Others won't, especially when speed limits are legally enforced on all motorway roadwork and Contraflow systems, with the added incentive of video cameras tracking culprits. Today there was the suggestion that those tapes may be used as evidence in court under future legislation. New laws are all well and good, though, but they have to be enforced. Chief constables are being consulted about making enough officers available to make the laws stick. Government and police agree the real answer to motorway danger lies with the motorists themselves.
For one aspect, the public will reduce its speed if it knows that it's got to. When it comes to enforcement, yes, it does involve a lot of police resources and a lot of police time. But if we advertise the fact through the media that people are likely to be prosecuted, that in itself is good enforcement.
The M25 is under review, and an experimental speed limit is being introduced southbound on the London end of the M1. But the main message from today was a call for better driving all round. Tricia Ingrams, Thames News. All the problems are